take a step on this, Mark. And whenever you're ready, go ahead and tell Chadwick what he and the movie mean to you.
Darren here, just want to say thank you so much for making Black Panther. I can't express how much it means to me and in the community and my family. Thank you from the very bottom of my heart for all that you've done, for really being a hero that we really need in a time like this. Thank you so much.
Darren, I think there's something wrong with your microphone.
Oh! My king.
I cannot tell you how much it means to have you step into the role as our king and be holding it with such grace and poise and joy.
That was so great. I think we should move in for a close up of that. Let's get a close up of that right there.
Well, for me, as the mother of a young son, my son's childhood has been defined by Barack Obama and now Black Panther, so thank you.
Hey, that's way too much praise for Barack Obama.
You are
gorgeous. Gorgeous family.
That is unexpected.
Gorgeous family.
Thank you. Wow, what a surprise.
All of it's been very personal, just watching the kids experiencing, and for me, I would say, you know, they're two little kids, Ian and Taylor, who recently passed. What they said to me is, and their parents said, they're trying to hold on till this movie comes, and to a certain degree, you hear them say that and you're like, wow, that's like, I gotta get up and go to the gym. I gotta get up and go to work. You know, I gotta learn these lines. I gotta work on this accent. You know, seeing how devoted all of my castmates are and knowing that will be something meaningful to them. But it's, to a certain degree, it's a humbling experience because you're like, this can't mean that much to them, you know? But seeing how the world has taken this on, seeing how the movement is, how it's taken on a life of its own, I realized that they anticipated something great. And I think back now to a kid and just, you know, waiting for Christmas to come, waiting for my birthday to come, waiting for a toy that I was going to get a chance to experience, or a video game. I did live life waiting for those moments, and so it put me back in the mind of being a kid just to experience those two little boys. Anticipation of this movie, and when I found out that they
it's the only thing I got left, and it's so hard to confess
at the time with it,
when everybody thinks you're perfect, but I cry for you.
Yeah, it means a lot.
And I cry for you. If it's so hard to lose, the elephant's in the room.
Just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you. I'll find you. I'll find you. Just hold on and I'll find you.
I'm hanging on by a thread, and all I'm clinging to is prayers. And every breath is like a battle. I feel like I ain't come prepared. And death's knocking on the front door. Pain's creeping through the back. Fears crawling through the windows, waiting for them to attack. They say don't get bitter, get better. I'm working on switching them letters. But tell God I'ma need a whole lot of hope keeping it together. I'm smiling in everyone's face. I'm crying whenever they leave the room. They don't know the battle I face. They don't understand what I'm going through. The world trying to play with my soul. I'm just trying to find where to go. I'm trying to remember the way. I'm trying to get back to my home. But I can't do this on my own. That's why I'm just trusting in you. Cause I don't know where else to go. And I don't know what else to
fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you. Just fight a little longer, my friend. It's all worth it in the end. But when you got nobody to turn to, just hold on and I'll find you. I'll find you. I'll find you. Just hold on and I'll find you. I'll find you. I'll find you. Just hold on and I'll find you.
They say fear haunts you and pain hates. I say pain strengthens. And fear drives faith. And I don't know all of the outcomes. Don't know what happens tomorrow. But when that ocean of doubt comes, don't let me drown in my sorrow. And don't let me stay at the bottom. I feel like this hole is too deep to climb. I've been looking for a way out, but I settle for a peace of mind. Picking up the pieces of my life and hoping that I put together something right. Tell me all I got is all I need. Tell me you gon' help me stay and fight. The world tryna play with my soul. I'm just tryna find where to go. I'm tryna remember the way. I'm tryna get back to my home. But I can't do this on my own. That's why I'm just trusting in you. Cause I don't know where else to go. And I don't know what else to do.
No, don't let the fear make you feel like you can't fight this on your own.
We begin tonight with the sudden and very tragic death sending shockwaves across the country. Actor Chadwick Boseman died at the age of 43 following a private four-year battle with colon cancer. Boseman inspiring millions with his roles, making seven movies while quietly undergoing surgeries and chemotherapy treatments. He's perhaps best known for his groundbreaking role right here in Black Panther, a watershed moment for African-American filmmakers and audiences alike. Boseman also portraying black icons like Jackie Robinson, James Brown, and Thurgood Marshall. His passing coming on the same day Major League Baseball honored the real Jackie Robinson.
Chadwick Boseman. His widow accepted on his behalf.
He would say something beautiful, something that would amplify that little voice inside of all of us that tells you you can, that tells you to keep going. I don't have his words. But we have to take all the moment to celebrate those we love. So thank you.
What did he mean to you as a friend?
He's a special person. It's a tragic loss.
Such an honor and a privilege to be able to recall and to have that memory of every morning sitting next to him in the makeup trailer as he's, you know, making, as he's preparing himself. Sometimes he's actually on a call to someone in South Africa getting the accent right or the, you know, some information that he needed to just invest in the character, whether we as the audience would see that or not, something that he knew and held on to. And then at our premiere, which was one of the most phenomenal nights of a lifetime, I remember leaving, about to depart. It had been glorious. Great music, great people, great enthusiasm. Just a complete high. And I just made a beeline to give him an embrace and say, you know, good night. And he whispered that he was a student that was assigned to me when I received my honorary doctorate at Howard University, which was his alma mater at the time. And I couldn't believe that he had held that information here all this time that we had worked together, but we know we hold things close. But it was wonderful because, you know, people say, I want to work with you from time to time. And you say, yeah, that would be great. I look forward to that. But in actuality, it's a rare thing.
Oh, shout out right there. And we premiered the first footage from Black Panther 1. And sitting next to me, right to my left, was R. T'Challa, the late, great Chadwick Boseman. And the cast, including Chad, they hadn't seen the footage yet. So when we played it, you know, he was right next to me and he was excited. And he grabbed my left shoulder with his hand. And if you ever saw Chad in person, he had these enormous hands. It was just gigantic. It was part of the reason why he filled out the Panther suit so well. And he was really, really strong. And he was getting excited as the clip went on and on, longer and longer. He was just squeezing down on my shoulder the whole time. And when it went off, he was like, oh man, that was amazing, congratulations. And I couldn't even lift my arm, you know what I mean? Like, you know, and I felt his hand the rest of that day for a few hours, you know what I mean? And standing here with y'all right now, listening to that music from all those artists and thinking about it all, I promise you I can feel his hand on me right now. So thank y'all for that. I love it. And Chad is no longer with us physically, but his spirit, his passion, his genius, his pride in his culture, and the impact that he made on this industry will be felt forever.
I'm feeling how you miss, how much you're missing your friend tonight.
I'm missing it a whole lot. You know, I've been meditating on, you know, I had to really face the fact that we were going forward with Black Panther without him. And every day on set, we had to deal with that. Find hope, find a reason to do it, and really, I did it to honor his legacy and to further his legacy and to carry on what he started and started so beautifully. You know, I think Black Panther means so much to so many people. We owe it to him to carry it forward, and so today, I feel his absence, but I feel his presence too.
When he said that, I really was like, so much sense of just concerning the man he was and what he did for the culture and for his people and his focus therein and his commitment therein. And so it was so clear to me once I heard that. And then it was just about giving it 100% all the time because it was all about honoring the check.
I feel for me it's a beautiful contribution to Chadwick's legacy. I feel like it's a love letter to him. I know every day that I went on set, I focused my energy on each scene to dedicate it to him. I wanted to dedicate excellence to this film so that he could be proud.
We love him. Oh my goodness. I can't wait.
I can't believe that I was so lucky. I can't believe that I got to love this person. And I also got them to love me too.
Simone, you're with me every day. I have to acknowledge you right now. Love you. God, you want me to preach a sermon? I feel like I'm living in my purpose. But the funny thing about purpose is that it unfolds more and more to you every day. So you can be living in what was revealed to you at a particular time, and then you might get stagnated because there's more that you're supposed to do. It doesn't just stop as you do one thing. So I think it's just being open to what you're supposed to do at this moment, not getting stuck in the past, because purpose is not related to career. Purpose is not related to a job. It's related to what God put inside you that you're supposed to give to the world. And you can do that in various different positions and forms. So I think it's staying open to what that essence is at all times. All right, that's three questions. Y'all almost made me preach a sermon.